Hey guys, this is Yves from Dynamic Digital. I hope you're okay. Today I wanted to share with you how to create the dashboard I created for the COVID-19 pandemic. And I wanted to explain you how I created it using Google Data Studio. So Google Data Studio is a very good tool to create any kind of dashboards. I usually use it for websites analytics, but you can use it for really diverse things. So let me show you quickly how I did that. So this is the final dashboard. So it's interactive. So if you move around your mouse, you can actually check information. So data is interactive. You can check countries, check here, depending on the days you want the information for. So it's very powerful. It's really modern. And is very easily shareable, so you can embed it on websites, you can share it online on Facebook, YouTube, anything. So it's very good, and so you can even just check data for, you can add filters, for example. So it's really powerful solution. So basically, let's jump into it. So I created that based on official data, of course. So the official map is the one from the Johns Hopkins Institute. And they created this dashboard here. And it's very nice, but of course it's very heavy. So the dashboard I created here actually is for digital signage purpose. So it's to show on LCD displays and full HD display. So the information had to be more more easily understood and more visible as well. So I used larger fonts, and I used different setup to display the information, which is more in line with the medium I will use, which is display. So I simply went here in the information, and I can see that the downloadable database is on GitHub. So I clicked here, and I went to the COVID-19 data, and I have the daily reports over here, and here I just pick the last report that I can click here. I got some data here, and I will click option or shift, and I will download what is called the CSV file. So once I've done this, I will go back to my Google Data Studio, and I will just create a blank report. So I click here, and my report is blank. It asks me what I want to put in my report. So I simply go to file upload, because I have a CSV file. And I click here to upload some file, and I select the file I just downloaded. So once I've done this, it's gonna process the file. I will need to wait, 1 minute maybe, or some, 10 seconds, it depends. It just says processing over here. Okay, it's uploaded, and I will add it. So now I have added the sources, the data sources, to create my my chart, my dashboard. So I will delete this, and I will start creating it. I prefer personally a darker background, so I just go with this. So I select here on the right in the theme and layout, I will select the style, and I will start adding charts and data. So I will just go to scoreboard here. I will add it here. Here we go. And we'll make it a bit bigger, for example. And here on the right, I have my data sources. And of course, by default, the CSV file I downloaded is, I uploaded is actually selected, so I don't need to care about this. The data range, the date range dimension is by default as well, last update. So depending on the file you're using, maybe different value here. And the metric is the most important, is what we'll show over here. So the metric here I will select is, I want to show confirmed cases. Here we go. So it will pull from the CSV the confirmed cases. So here basically is all the information I can pull from this file I uploaded. So I will use confirmed cases, and I will slightly change the style. I will change the size of the font, Here we go. I will center the information and I will put some color to it. I will extend it. Here we go. Once I've done this, I will duplicate it. I will put it here and I will change the data. So instead of confirmed, I will use active. And for active, I will as well change the data. So the color. I will use orange. And here I will use for the data, not active, but I will use recovered. And I will change the style in green, because it's a good news, of course. So I want to use green. And here I will use, I just need to move it. Here I will use the metric depth here. And for this one, the style will be maybe more sober, and I will use maybe a transparent background, and I will just use a border. Let's check styles, border, and 1 pixel white. Here we go. So now I have my information over here. Something important I forgot to do is to actually change the resolution of my dashboard. So in this case, I want to use it for a 16 by 9 screen. So I will use this. And I want to set up the resolution exactly to 1920 by 1080. And so like this, I'm sure I can use it for digital signage purposes, which is what I want to use it for. Or even it could work very well for web purposes as well in this case. So you can change that as you need. Actually, very important as well is the display mode. And here I will fit to width. Because if I don't do that, if my display resolution is different than 1920 by 1080, then what can happen is that it would actually be too big or too small, you know. So I want to fit it so it's responsive to the resolution I'm using. So not that I've got these data here, I will make it a bit bigger. Here we go. Can make it very big, for example. I will change the style again just to make it fit, so I can increase the size of the font and add some padding on the top, for example, to center it slightly. Here we go. And here in the middle I will add another chart, which will be a time series chart, which would help me maybe visualize actually the more data from this. And we could as well add a map, which is very useful in this case. So maybe let's start with the map, and then we can see if we want to add something else. There we go. So here by default it's charging again my data source. The date range dimension is correct, and the geo dimension is the country region. So my metric is again the most important thing I want to check. So here I want to show the confirmed cases. Here we go. I could as well show the depth, for example, if I wanted to, and so it would be slightly different map coloring. So for example, in this case, we could see Italy is the more depth so far. So I will just say confirmed. And I will slightly change the style of it, and I will go for a more reddish tint. Here we go, to match with my confirm thing here. So as you see, I already quickly created the dashboard. I already quickly imported the data. It's very easy, very fast. And of course, I can do other things. For example, with the map, if I want to show Europe, for example, I could do that. Here we go, and then I have a zoom on Europe. I want to show the world. Here we go. And I think that's very good like this. And I can, of course, change the style, add some information, for example, add some options. So for example, here, what can I do with the map? I wanted to don't show the legend, for example, so things like this. So once I've made all this, I will select everything. I think here we go. I will add maybe a title to it. So here I will go to text, and I will type COVID-19 dashboard worldwide status or situation. Worldwide situation. I will again here increase the size of the font. I think 72 sounds good. Here we go. I will maybe bold it, and I will rename my dashboard as well with the same name as this. So instead of entitled report, it will have a specific name. And what I can do as well is add some date range, for example, here. So like this, people, when they visit, they can actually select a date range. We could as well add some filter control, and in the filter control, I want to, again, in the metric, I want to check the countries, for example. So I will go here, oops, countries, regions, here we go. So I'm gonna check if everything works fine. So for example, if I just want to show USA, I can do this. If I just want to show France, for example, I can do this. Yeah, so it's filtering for me all the data in life. And if I want to go back in time, for example, to see a few days before, I could actually see that, you know. So here it's not working, maybe I need to check, I think, because simply I was in the wrong, so it's not April, but it's March. So for example, 25th of March, and here I could have different data. So actually it's easier here. So let's say, for example, I want to check yesterday. I apply and I can check the data from yesterday. So here we go. I will edit it and just change the name here of the, so I will click on this little dot here and say select your region. And like that, here you can see it's written. So now what I want to do, I want to share it, and I simply go to share. I click here, I click on manage access, and here I want anyone on the internet, you know, can access it. And I will just simply copy the link. Here we go, click copy, and here I will just copy the link, and actually I can share it. So as you see, it's very easy, it's very fast once you know what to do and where, when you know how to get information. I will do more tutorials like this about Google Data Studio, especially regarding website analytics and how you can use it to actually get more information about who visits your website and how is your website doing on the internet. So thank you very much for watching. Take care of yourself and your family. And see you next time. Bye.